أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. قل هو الله أحد، الله الصمد، لم يلد ولم يولد، ولم يكن له كفوا أحد.
وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله.
Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim, all praise is due to Allah, Lord of all that exists, and may the salat and salam upon of Allah be upon our Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam.
اخواني في يوم من الايام توجه امير المؤمنين عمر الخطاب رضي الله عنه من المدينه الى مكه.
One day Umar رضي الله عنه, who was the Khalifa of the time, he left from Medina and he went to Mecca.
فاستقبله والي مكه خارج حدود مكة يستقبل أمير المؤمنين.
And the governor of Mecca came to greet Umar outside of the outskirts of Mecca.
فقال له أمير المؤمنين عمر رضي الله عنه كيف تترك مكة؟ من وليت على مكة عندما خرجت إلي؟
So Umar رضي الله عنه asked the governor of Mecca, who did you leave behind in your place as your deputy once you left Mecca?
قال تركت عليها واليا ابن أبزة. قال تركت عليها واليا يقال له ابن أبزة.
He said that I left a man as my deputy by the name of Ibn Abza.
قال له عمر رضي الله عنه من ابن أبزة؟
So he asked him, who is this man Ibn Abza?
هل هو من العرب أم من غير العرب؟
Is he an Arab or a non-Arab?
قال من غير العرب.
He said he's a non-Arab.
قال ويحك كيف تولي على قريش رجلا من غير العرب على مكة؟
So Umar said, woe to you, how can you possibly leave as the governor of Mecca over the people of Quraysh, a man who is not even an Arab?
فقال يا أمير المؤمنين إنه حافظ قارئ لكتاب الله عز وجل.
So the governor replied and he said, oh Umar, he is a man who has recited and memorized the Quran.
فسكت عمر رضي الله عنه.
So Umar رضي الله عنه went quiet.
ثم قال له صدقت.
And he said to him, you have spoken the truth.
إِنَّ اللَّهَ لَيَرْفَعُ بِهَذَا الْقُرْآنِ أَقْوَامًا وَيَضَعُ بِهِ آخَرِينَ
For indeed Allah will raise people through this Quran and he will cause others to be humiliated.
ولذا قيل بأن الإمام الزهري أتى إلى الملك عبد الملك إلى الخليفة عبد الملك بن مروان
And on another occasion, a scholar by the name of Imam al-Zuhri, he came to the Khalifa of his time, Abdul Malik ibn Marwan.
فرحب به.
And he welcomed the Khalifa, welcomed the scholar.
فقال له من تركت سيدا على المدينة.
And he asked him, who did you find to be the leader of the people of Medina?
بحيث هو سيد عليها يحبه الناس ويتعلق به الناس.
Meaning that he is a leader in terms of he has the affection of the people and their love.
وهو عالمها.
And he is the most knowledgeable from amongst them.
قال نافع.
He said that I left نافع. I found نافع to be that individual.
قال من العرب أم من غير العرب؟
He said, is this man نافع from the Arabs or the non-Arabs?
قال من غير العرب.
The scholar said, he's from the non-Arabs.
قال بما ساده.
So he asked, the Khalifa asked, how did he get that position over them?
قال بكتاب الله عز وجل.
He replied, it was through the book of Allah.
قال ومن تركت يسود مكة؟
So he asked him, the Khalifa asked the scholar, and who is the leader in this respect of Mecca?
قال عطاء.
He said, عطاء.
قال من العرب أم من غير العرب؟
He asked, is this man عطاء from the Arabs or the non-Arabs?
فقال من غير العرب.
He said, from the non-Arabs.
قال ويحك.
He said, woe to you.
ومن تركت يسود اليمن؟
And what about the person who the people of Yemen love and respect?
قال طاووس.
He said a man by the name of طاووس.
قال من العرب أم من غير العرب؟
He asked, is this طاووس an Arab or a non-Arab?
قال من غير العرب.
He said, is a non-Arab.
قال ويحك ومن تركت يسود البصرة.
He said, woe to you, and who is the leader of the people of Basra?
قال الحسن البصري.
He said, الحسن البصري.
قال من العرب أم من غير العرب؟
He asked, is this man الحسن البصري an Arab or a non-Arab?
قال من غير العرب.
He said, is a non-Arab.
قال ويحك ومن تركت يسود الجزيرة العراق.
And he asked him, so who is the leader of the people of Iraq?
قال الضحاك بن مزاحم.
He said a man by the name of الضحاك بن مزاحم.
قال من العرب من غير العرب.
He asked him, is he an Arab or a non-Arab?
قال من غير العرب.
He said he's a non-Arab.
قال ويحك ومن تركت يسود فارس.
So he said, woe to you, and who is the leader of the people of Persia?
قال ميمون بن مهران.
He said, ميمون بن مهران.
قال العرب من غير العرب.
He asked, is he an Arab or non-Arab?
قال من غير العرب.
He said, he's a non-Arab.
قال ويحك.
He said, woe to you.
ومن تركت يسود مصر.
And who is the leader of the people of Hashem, people of Egypt?
قال يزيد ابن أبي حبيب.
He said, it is a man by the name of Yazid.
قال من العرب من غير العرب.
He asked, is he an Arab or a non-Arab?
قال من غير العرب.
He said, a non-Arab.
قال ويحك ومن تركت يسود الشام.
He said, woe to you, and who is the leader of the people of Hashem?
قال مكحول.
He said, مكحول.
من العرب أم من غير العرب؟ قال من غير العرب.
Is he an Arab or a non-Arab? He said, he's a non-Arab.
قال ومن تركت يسود الكوفة.
And what about the leader of the people of Kufa?
قال إبراهيم النخعي.
He said, it is Ibrahim al-Nakhai.
قال من العرب من غير العرب.
Is he an Arab or a non-Arab?
قال من العرب.
He said, he's an Arab.
قال فرجت عني يا زهري.
He said, finally we found an Arab.
قال يا أمير المؤمنين.
He said, O leader of the Muslims.
إن الله لا يرفع بهذا القرآن أقواما ويضع به آخرين.
Indeed, Allah will raise people by the Quran, and He will cause others to be humiliated.
كل هؤلاء سادوا غير العرب. كل هؤلاء من غير العرب سادوا العرب لأنهم كانوا قارئين وعالمين بكتاب الله عز وجل.
All of these scholars and their names that we mentioned were non-Arab, but they were the leaders over the Arabs because of their knowledge of the Book of Allah.
ولذا قال النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم في حديث الإمام أحمد.
And that is why the Prophet said, صلى الله عليه وسلم, in the hadith collected by Imam Ahmad.
يقال لصاحب القرآن.
That it will be said to the person who memorizes the Quran.
اقرأ وارتق.
Read and recite and ascend in levels.
ورتل كما كنت ترتل في الدنيا.
And recite on this day as you used to recite in the world.
فإن منزلتك.
For indeed your final place.
عند آخر آية كنت تقرأها في الدنيا.
It will be with the last verse that you memorized in this world.
الذي يرفع الناس يوم القيامة وفي الدنيا هو كتاب الله عز وجل.
So what raises a person's station in this life and the next year is the book of Allah.
فصاحب كتاب الله عز وجل هو من أهل الله وخاصته.
So the person who memorizes the Quran, this person is from the special people of Allah.
لذا روى الإمام أحمد أن النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم قال.
And that is why Imam Ahmad collected that our Prophet said, صلى الله عليه وسلم.
قال أهل القرآن هم أهل الله وخاصته.
He said that the people of the Quran, they are the special people of Allah سبحانه وتعالى.
فهم أخص الناس بالله عز وجل.
And they are the chosen, selected few that Allah chooses.
وهم أقرب الناس إلى الله تبارك.
And they are the people most closest to Allah.
إن الذين يتلون كتاب الله.
Allah says that those who recite the book of Allah.
وأقاموا الصلاة.
And they establish the prayer.
وأنفقوا مما رزقناهم سرا وعلانية.
And they spend from that which we have provided for them in open and in secret.
يرجون تجارة لن تبور.
They hope for a commerce and a transaction that will never fail.
ليوفيهم
Allah will give them their full reward.
ويزيدهم من فضله.
And He will increase them from His grace.
إنه غفور شكور.
Indeed, He is of forgiving, one who shows gratitude.
وقال بأن الإمام أحمد رأى الله عز وجل في المنام.
It is said that Imam Ahmad رحمه الله once saw Allah in a dream.
فقال الإمام أحمد سائلا الله عز وجل.
So Imam Ahmad asked Allah in his dream.
يا ربي.
Oh my Lord.
ما أفضل ما تقرب به المتقربون. إليك.
What is the greatest or the best deed that a person can perform in order to draw nearer to you?
قال بكلامي.
And Allah responded in the dream, it is through my words.
فكلما اقتربت من كلام الله اقتربت من الله عز وجل.
So the closer you come to the speech of Allah, the closer you become to Allah.
بل إنك عندما تقرأ كتاب الله, الله عز وجل يستمع إليك.
But rather when you recite the book of Allah and His verses, Allah listens to you Himself.
وكلما ازدادت مكانتك وازداد وحسنت صوتك كلما استمع الله عز وجل إليك أكثر.
And the more beautiful your recitation and more melodious it is, the more that Allah listens to it.
ولذا روى إمام مسلم عن النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم أنه قال.
And that is why Imam Muslim, he collected the hadith that the Prophet said, صلى الله عليه وسلم,
ما أذن الله لشيء, ما استمع الله لشيء,
that Allah doesn't listen to anything,
ما أذن لنبي حسن الصوت,
the way that he listens to a prophet who recites with a beautiful voice,
يتغنى بالقرآن,
he recites melodiously the Quran,
يجهر به,
and he recites out loud.
فكلما حسنت صوتك كلما استمع الله عز وجل.
So the more beautiful your voice is in your recitation, the more that Allah will listen.
وكلما ازدادت فضيلتك عند الله كلما استمع الله عز وجل.
And the greater your station before Allah, the more that Allah listens.
وقيل على قدر اهتمامك بكلام الله وبقراءة كتاب الله.
And it is based upon your eagerness to learn and to read the book of Allah.
سيكرمك الله عز وجل بالجزاء من جنس العمل.
Allah عز وجل will reward you accordingly.
ورد عن أحد التابعين أنه قال.
It is said that one of the scholars of the Tabi'in said.
إن أهل الجنة يدخلون الجنة.
That the people of paradise will enter paradise.
يدخلون على الجبار على الله عز وجل في اليوم مرتين.
That they will have an audience with Allah twice a day.
فيقرأ عليهم القرآن.
And he will read to them the Quran.
ولكل منا يريد أن يستمع إلى الله عز وجل وهو يقرأ القرآن.
Who from amongst us wouldn't want to hear Allah reciting His own Quran?
عندما تستمع صوتا جميل تستمع إلى صوت جميل يقرأ كتاب الله.
When you listen to a beautiful recitation in this world reciting the Quran.
يتعلق قلبك. بهذا القرآن وبالقارئ.
You feel that your heart has become attached to the Quran and to the reciter.
فكيف إذا كان القارئ هو الله عز وجل؟
So what if that reciter is Allah Himself?
يقرأ كلامه فتستمع أنت لكلام الله عز وجل.
And he is reciting his own speech and you are listening to his words.
ويقول النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم.
And the Prophet said, صلى الله عليه وسلم.
خيركم من تعلم القرآن وعلمه.
The best of you are those who learn the Quran and they teach it.
ولذا صاحب القرآن كما روى الإمام مسلم.
And that is why that the person of the Quran, as the Imam Muslim collected.
النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم أنه قال.
That the Prophet said, صلى الله عليه وسلم, concerning him.
اقرأوا القرآن.
Read the Quran.
فإنه يأتي يوم القيامة شفيعا لأصحابه.
For it will come on the day of judgment as an intercessor for its people.
يشفع لك عند الله عز وجل.
It will intercede on your behalf before Allah.
كلما اقتربت العقوبة منك أتى القرآن وشفع لك.
Every time some punishment comes to you or draws close to you, the Quran will come and intercede on your behalf.
وهذه كرامة من الله عز وجل.
And this is a special position from Allah.
ويقول النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم.
The Prophet said, صلى الله عليه وسلم.
الماهر بالقرآن.
The one who is proficient in the Quran.
مع السفرة الكرام البر أي الملائكة.
He will be with the noble angels.
والذي يقرأ القرآن.
And as for the one who recites the Quran, and he has difficulty in its recitation, and it is difficult for him to read it, he will have double the reward. So this hadith, which is in Bukhari and Muslim, the Prophet ﷺ goes on to say, that the one who is proficient in the Quran, he is in the company of the angels.
فتحوطه الملائكة.
Meaning that the angels will surround him.
تذكره بالخير.
And they will remind him of good.
قد يقدم على المعصية فتأتي الملائكة وتحجبه وتمنعه عن الوقوع في المعصية.
And perhaps this person wants to perform a sin, but the angels come and they prevent him from that sin.
وربما قد يسقط فتأتي الملائكة وتحفظه من السقوط.
And perhaps this person falls down or they make a mistake and the angels come and they help him.
وإذا جلس مجلسا يتلو فيه القرآن أو يعلم الناس كلام الله عز وجل تحفه الملائكة.
And when he is reciting the Quran or is teaching the Quran, then the angels come and they surround that gathering.
كما قال النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم.
As the Prophet said, صلى الله عليه وسلم.
ما جلس قوم مجلسا يتلون كتاب الله.
That a group of people do not sit together to read the book of Allah.
ويتدارسونه.
And to study it.
إلا نزلت عليهم السكينة.
Except that tranquility descends upon them.
وغشيتهم الرحمة.
And mercy envelops them.
وحفتهم الملائكة.
And the angels surround them.
وذكرهم الله في من عنده.
And Allah عز وجل mentions them within His company.
فالملائكة تحفك وتجلس في المجالس التي تجلس أنت فيها لأنك حافظ لكتاب الله وتعلم الناس كتاب الله عز وجل.
So the angels come and they attend those gatherings in which you sit as a person who's memorized the Quran and you teach the Quran to others.
بل ربما إذا كنت تقيم الليل.
And if perhaps you spend the night awake in prayer.
وقد احيانا ربما فقط تستيقظ لصلاه الفجر.
And sometimes if you were to wake up just for fajr.
ونسيت ان تضبط المنبه.
And sometimes you forget to set your alarm clock.
قد تستيقظ في نفس الوقت الذي يوقظك فيه المنبه.
Perhaps you will wake up anyway at the same time that you would have set your alarm.
وتقول من الذي ايقظني.
And then you wonder, how did you happen to wake up at that same time?
ولا تعلم من الذي أيقظك.
And you don't know what caused you to wake up.
فإذا الملائكة هي التي قد أيقظتك.
It is the angels who came and they woke you.
حتى تصلي الليل أو حتى تصلي الفجر.
So that you can pray that night and you can pray your fajr.
فالملائكة تحوطك مع السفرات الكرام البرر.
So the angels come and they support you and surround you.
وإذا تواجدت الملائكة تطرد الشياطين.
And when the angels come, then they expel the devils.
ففي مجالسك ففي مجلسك تقل الشياطين وتهرب الشياطين.
And so in the gatherings where you are, the devils they disperse.
لأنك مع السفرة الكرام البرر.
Because in those same gatherings there are noble angels.
بالربما كذلك عند الموت تذكرك الملائكة.
And even at the time of death they come and they support you.
وتذكرك بالشهادتين.
And they remind you of saying the shahada.
وقد حصل هذا لمجموعة من القراء.
And this is something which happened to a number of known reciters of the Quran.
الإمام القارئ يسمى بالنقاش وهو أحد القراء التابعين من أتباع التابعين.
One of the famous scholars of the Quran, a man by the name of النقاش.
يقول أبو الحسن القطان حضرته النقاش وهو يجود بنفسه أي يحتضر تكاد الروح تخرج منه.
Someone said that I came to the scholar النقاش at the time of his death.
فجعل يحرك شفتيه.
And I found that his lips were moving.
ثم نادى بأعلى صوته.
And then he said out loud.
لمثل هذا فليعمل العاملون.
Let the people act and let them work.
ما هو الذي يعمله العاملون؟
What is this that he's referring to?
أكمل أولئك لهم رزق معلوم.
He continued and he said that those people will have a well-known provision.
فواكه وهم مكرمون.
They will have fruits and they will be honored.
أي في جنات النعيم.
In blessed gardens.
ففاضت روحه إلى الله عز وجل.
And then he passed away.
فالله عز وجل أحاطه بالملائكة.
So Allah caused the angels to come to him at this time and support him.
وأبو جعفر هذا من القراء العشرة.
And also Abu Ja'far, one of the 10 قراء.
لما توفي أبو جعفر.
When he passed away.
كشف عن صدره.
They exposed his chest.
فإذا على صدره كأن صفحة بيضاء على صدره كأن صفحة بيضاء صدره كله أصبح صفحة بيضاء.
They found that his chest was like a white blank page.
يقول من حضر يقول كأنها اللبن صدره كأنه لبن.
It's as white as milk.
قالوا والله هذا كنا نقول بأن هذا كله نور القرآن.
Then they said to one another, the people that saw this, they said that we think that this is from the light of the Quran.
فهكذا قارئ القرآن يكون دائما مع الله عز وجل.
So the one who recites the Quran is a person who is constantly with Allah.
وتحفظه الملائكة.
And the angels preserve him.
كذلك إخواني من القراء.
Also from the well-known reciters of the Quran.
أبو منصور الخياط.
أبو منصور الخياط.
كان عالم من علماء القراءات.
He was from the scholars of قراءات.
رأوه بعد الموت.
They saw him. Someone saw him after his death in a dream.
قالوا ما فعل الله بك؟
And they asked him in the dream, what did Allah do with you after your death?
غفر لي بتعليمي الصبيان. فاتحة الكتاب.
He said that Allah forgave me because I would teach the young children how to read Surah Al-Fatiha.
وهكذا أصحاب القرآن تتنزل عليهم الملائكة.
And this is how the people of the Quran, the angels descend upon them.
قبل مماتهم وبعد مماتهم.
Before their deaths and after their deaths.
إن الذين قالوا ربنا الله.
Indeed, those who say that our Lord is Allah.
ثم استقاموا.
And they are firm upon this.
تتنزل عليهم الملائكة.
The angels will descend upon them.
ألا تخافوا.
And they will say, do not fear.
ولا تحزن.
No despair.
وأبشروا بالجنة التي كنتم توعدون.
And have glad tidings of the paradise that you were promised.
وهو على فراش الموت بشره الملائكة لا تخشى.
This is the glad tidings that they are given at the time of death by the angels.
نحن أولياءكم في الحياة الدنيا.
And the angels say that we are your protectors in this life and the next.
وفي الآخرة.
And in the hereafter.
من هؤلاء ثابت البناني وهو أحد التابعين.
From amongst these well-known scholars of the Quran is a scholar of the Tabi'in by the name of Thabit al-Bunani.
يقول ابنه وهو محمد.
his son Muhammad said,
ذهبت ألقن أبي وهو يحتضر ألقنه الشهادتين.
He said, at the time of my father's death, I was reminding him to say لا إله إلا الله.
قلت يا أبا قل لا إله إلا الله.
And I said to him, oh my father, say لا إله إلا الله.
قال يا بني.
He responded and he said, oh my son,
خلي عني.
Leave me alone.
فإني في وردي السادس قبل الأخير لأختم القرآن.
He said, because I am reading my Quran and I've nearly finished reciting the whole Quran. And a scholar by the name of Abdullah ibn Idris, at the time of his death, on his deathbed, his daughter began to cry. So he said to her, don't cry, oh my daughter. He said, because verily in this same house that we live in, I finished the whole Quran over 4,000
times.
One of our contemporary reciters of the Quran, a reciter by the name of Muhammad Ali al-Banna, the final recitation of the Quran that he did out loud was the verse of Allah, oh Allah, cause me to die as a Muslim and give me the company of the righteous. And then he passed away. One of the scholars of the Quran in the King Fahd printing complex in Medina.
واسمه عامر السيد عثمان.
His name is Amir Sayyid Uthman.
وهو شيخ القراء في مجمع الملك فهد.
And he is one of the teachers of all of the different reciters in Medina.
في آخر حياته مدة 7 سنوات فقد أحباله الصوتية.
For 7 years before he passed away, for 7 years he lost his vocal cords. He couldn't speak.
فما يستطيع أن يتكلم.
He couldn't speak and talk.
مكث في المستشفى.
He was in hospital.
إلى قبل وفاته بثلاثة أيام.
Until before he passed away by 3 days.
فقبل وفاته بثلاثة أيام سمعوا صوتا سمع أهل المستشفى صوتا يخرج من غرفته في المستشفى.
3 days before he passed away, people heard noises coming from his room in the hospital.
دخلوا عليه فإذا هو يدندن القرآن يقرأ القرآن.
They came into his room and they found him reciting the Quran out loud.
تعجبوا منه.
They were amazed.
فقد أحباله الصوتية 7 سنوات.
7 years this man hasn't been able to speak.
فإذا هو يقرأ القرآن من حفظه.
And now he's reading the Quran from memory.
من الفاتحة من البقرة وأخذ يكمل.
And he's going from Fatiha to Surah Baqarah and he's continuing.
في اليوم الثالث.
On the third day.
أنهى وانتهى إلى سورة الناس.
He finished the Quran and he finished سورة الناس.
أول ما انتهى من سورة الناس فاضت روحه إلى الله.
And as soon as he finished سورة الناس, he finished the Quran, he passed away.
كان الله عز وجل معه.
Allah عز وجل was with him.
الإمام الطيبي كان دائما يجلس بعد الفجر يستخرج دقائق القرآن ويعلم الناس دقائق القرآن.
He would sit with the people after Fajr and he would take from the Quran its wisdoms and its lessons and he would share them with the others.
ورأى النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم في المنام.
He saw the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم in a dream.
فناوله قدح من اللبن.
And the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم gave him a vessel of milk.
ثم بعد ذلك واستمر يفسر القرآن.
And he continued to teach people the Quran.
فانتهى من تفسيره مع أذان صلاة الظهر.
And he finished his tafsir by the time of Salatul Dhuhr.
صلى النافلة وأخذ ينتظر إقامة الظهر.
He prayed his optional prayers and he was waiting for the إقامة.
وهو مستقبل القبلة.
And he was facing the قبلة.
ففاضت روحه إلى الله.
And he passed away.
الماهر بالقرآن مع السفرة الكرام البررة.
So the one who is proficient with the Quran is with the noble angels.
الملائكة تكون معه.
And the angels are with him.
أخواني بل كذلك حتى رائحة فمه.
Even the scent and the smell that comes from such a person's mouth.
تتأثر بقراءة القرآن.
It is something which also is affected by the Quran.
روى البخاري ومسلم.
And Imam al-Bukhari and Muslim they narrated.
النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم قال.
That the Prophet said صلى الله عليه وسلم.
مثل الذي يقرأ القرآن.
The example of the one who recites the Quran.
كمثل أترجة.
It is like the example of the citron fruit.
ريحها طيب.
It has a pleasant smell.
وطعمها طيب.
And it's taste is pleasant.
أي لا يخرج منه إلا ما هو طيب وهو قراءة القرآن وتعليم الناس.
Meaning that everything that emanates from this person is good because it is from the Quran.
وكذلك تدبر القرآن طعمها طيب.
And likewise, this person contemplates the Quran and they find also sweetness in this.
وقد يكرمه الله عز وجل بطيب رائحة فمه.
And perhaps Allah also gives them a breath that is pleasant in its smell.
الإمام نافع معروف الإمام نافع من قراءته من القراءات العشر أو من قراءات السبع.
الإمام النافع one of the scholars of قراءات.
كان إذا تكلم تشم من فمه رائحة المسك.
When he would speak, people would smell his breath and he would smell of musk.
فقال له أحد طلبته.
So one of his students asked him.
أيها الشيخ هل تتطيب وتطيب فمك كلما جلست للقراءة؟
He asked him, O Sheikh, do you use perfume in your mouth before you speak?
قال لا.
He said no.
ما أمس طيبا.
I don't use perfume.
ولا أقرب طيبا.
Nor do I come near any perfume.
ولكني رأيت فيما يرى النائم.
But I saw in a dream.
رأيت النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم.
I saw the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم.
وهو يقرأ في فمي.
And I saw him reciting directly into my mouth.
فمن ذلك الوقت وأنا أشم رائحة طيبة من فمي.
And from that time, I feel that I have a pleasant smell in my mouth.
وهكذا حتى الفم قد يتغير وتطيب رائحته بسبب قراءتك.
So even the smell that comes from a person's mouth changes because of the recitation of the Quran.
أخواني قارئ القرآن وحافظ القرآن مستجاب الدعوة.
A person who is connected to the Quran and memorizes the Quran, the dua is answered.
أحد علماء القراءات وهو هشام بن عمار المقرئ.
هشام بن عمار one of the scholars of Quran.
قال سألت الله عز وجل سبع حوائج.
He said, I asked Allah for seven things.
فقضى لي ستا.
And Allah answered six of the seven.
وما أدري عن السابعة.
And I don't know about the seventh.
سألته أن يرزقني الحج ففعل.
I asked Allah to allow me to perform Hajj and I was able to do so.
سألت الله عز وجل أن يعمرني 100 سنة فعمرني 100 سنة وأنا أفوق 100 الآن.
And I asked Allah to allow me to live for 100 years and now I'm above the age of 100.
سألت الله عز وجل أن يجعلني محدثا عن رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم فأكرمني بأن أصبحت أحد المحدثين.
And I asked Allah that He makes me from the scholars of Hadith, and He made me from the scholars of Hadith.
سألت الله عز وجل أن يجعل الناس يغدون إلي في طلب العلم فأكرمني بذلك.
And I asked Allah that students of knowledge will come to me and seek me out as their teacher, and Allah did so for me.
سألت الله عز وجل أن أخطب على منبر دمشق فأكرمني بذلك.
And I asked Allah to allow me to give a sermon from the pulpit of Damascus, and He allowed me to do so.
سألت الله أن يرزقني 1,000 دينار حلالا فأكرمني.
And asked Allah to give me 1,000 dinars which are halal, which come from a good place, and He did so.
بقيت السابعة.
So only the seventh one now remains. Seventh دعاء.
سألت الله أن يغفر لي ولوالدي فلا أعلم.
I asked Allah to forgive me and my parents, and I don't know about this.
أحد علماء القراءات ويقال له ابن شنبوذ.
ابن شنبوذ another scholar of the Quran.
وكان يقرأ ببعض القراءات وآخر لا يوافقونه على قراءته.
He would read the Quran in a certain way and other scholars would disagree with him in his recitation.
فأمره الوزير أن يتوقف عن هذه القراءات التي لا يقبل بها العلماء.
So the minister of his time, one of the ministers, one of the leaders, he told him to stop reciting in this way.
وهو يقول بل هذا ثبت عن رسول الله فأقرأ به.
But he responded and said, no, this is a valid way of reciting the Quran and I will continue to recite it in this way.
فأمر به الوزير أن يؤتى به.
So then he was taken to the leader.
فضربه سبع درر أي سبع درر سبع ضربات بالعصا.
And he was struck and beaten with 7 lashes.
فأخذ يدعو على الوزير.
So he made dua against the leader. The scholar made the dua against the leader.
بأن يقطع الله يده.
That Allah should chop off his hand.
ويشتت شمله.
And that Allah Azza wa Jal should make his affairs go in disarray.
وكان الوزير مقربا إلى الخليفة.
And this minister or leader was close to the Khalifa of that time.
ما مرت الأيام.
And a few days passed by.
إلا واستجيب دعاؤه. إلا واستجاب الله عز وجل.
Except and Allah answered that دعاء.
فأبعد من الخليفة وأبغضه الخليفة.
The Khalifa all of a sudden disliked him.
وقطعت يده.
And his hand was taken off.
وخربت دياره.
And his lands were taken from him.
وذاق الذل.
And he found humiliation.
وسجن.
And he was imprisoned.
وأصبح في شر حال.
And he was in the worst of situations.
وهكذا لأن هؤلاء هم أهل الله وهم أخص الناس بالله.
Because these people of the Quran are special to Allah and close to Allah.
فيستجيب الله عز وجل دعاء.
And Allah responds to their du'as.
إخواني أحيانا كذلك قارئ القرآن قد يعطيه الله عز وجل ويكرمه بالفراسة.
Allah عز وجل gives to the people of the Quran an insight and an ability to know others.
إخواني من أكبر علماء القرآن الإمام الشاطبي.
الإمام الشاطبي is one of the greatest scholars of the Quran.
الإمام الشاطبي كان كفيفا.
He was a man who was blind.
وكان يصلي الفجر.
And he would pray Fajr.
ثم يجلس بين يديه الطلبة ويقرأ طالبا طالبا.
And then the students would come and they would read the Quran to him.
وكان الناس يأتون من الليل يتسابقون من يأتي أولا.
And the students would be waiting from the night in order to be the first one to read to the imam.
وكان يوميا أول من يبدأ أول ما يقول يقول من جاء أولا فليقرأ. الأول هو الذي يقرأ.
And when he would come being blind and not knowing who came first, he would say after Fajr, whoever came here first, let him come to me first.
ثم يقول من جاء ثانيا فليقرأ.
And then the second one can come.
في يوم الأيام.
One day.
يقول. أحدهم أتيت أول شخص أنا في هذا المسجد.
One of his students said that I was the first one to come to the masjid that morning.
فجلست.
And I sat.
فلما صلى الشيخ الشاطبي الإمام الشاطبي صلى الفجر.
And after we prayed Fajr with the Imam.
جلس.
He sat down.
فقال الإمام الشاطبي.
And he said.
من جاء ثانيا فليقرأ.
Whoever came second, let him come to me first. So he said, I was shocked.
وتعجب الطلبة.
And the other students were shocked.
فتقدم الثاني فبدأ يقرأ.
So the second student, the one who came second, came and began to read.
وبقيت أنا.
And I was still waiting.
أخذت أتفكر.
And I was thinking to myself.
ماذا حدث؟ ماذا فعلت أنا؟
What happened? Why did he miss me out?
بالأمس فارقت الشيخ على أحسن حال.
Yesterday I met the Sheikh and he was happy with me.
ما الذي جعل الشيخ يحرمني من هذا؟
So why today has he all of a sudden changed the order?
قال فأخذت أفكر ماذا فعلت.
He said, so I began to think about this.
تذكرت فإذا أنا استيقظت وأنا على جنابة.
And he said that I realized that I woke up in a state of ritual impurity, جنابة.
ولشدة حرصي أن أكون أولا نسيت وأن أغتسل من الجنابة.
And because I was so eager to come and be the first one, I forgot to take a bath.
فالله عز وجل أنطق الشيخ بالثاني ما أنطقه بالأول.
So Allah عز وجل gave him that insight. He knew that today the second one should come first.
فبادرت إلى مكان قريب من المسجد فاغتسلت من الجنابة.
He said so that I quickly left the masjid and I found a place that I could take a bath and I bathed.
فأتيت إلى المسجد فصليت الفجر.
And then I came back and I prayed Fajr again.
وإذا طالب هذا الطالب لم ينتهي من القراءة.
And that second student who was reading first was still reading.
فعندما جلست.
And then when I sat down.
انتهى هذا من القراءة.
This student finished his recitation.
فقال الشيخ من جاء أولا فليقرأ.
And then he said, the Sheikh said, whoever came first, let him come to me.
فقرأت بين يدي الشيخ.
And then I went to the Sheikh.
فأكرمه الله عز وجل مثل هذه الكرامات.
So Allah عز وجل gave him that ability to know.
ولذلك. الله تبارك وتعالى مع أهل القرآن.
So Allah عز وجل is with the people of the Quran.
فالله عز وجل يحوطه ويحفظه.
And Allah preserves them and He protects them.
والملائكة كذلك تحوطه وتحفظه.
And likewise the angels preserve them and protect them.
روى البخاري.
And Imam البخاري narrated.
عن أسيد بن حضير.
On the companion أسيد بن حضير.
قال كنت أقرأ في الليل أقيم الليل أقرأ القرآن.
He said that I would spend the night awake in prayer reading the Quran.
ولي فرس مربوط.
And I had next to me or near me a horse that was tied up.
وابني الصغير جعلته في الأرض بقربي وأنا أقرأ القرآن.
And I had a baby, a child that I placed close by the horse as I was praying.
فأخذت أقرأ القرآن في الليل بالصلاة.
And I began to recite the Quran in prayer.
فجأة.
All of a sudden.
فإذا الفرس فرسي المربوطة أخذت تضطرب.
My horse that was tied up began to stamp.
فسكنت.
So I stopped reading.
سكت فسكنت.
And likewise the horse stopped stamping.
فبدأت أقرأ القرآن.
So then I started to recite again.
فاضطربت الخيل.
And likewise the horse also became agitated and began to stamp.
فسكت.
So I stopped reading.
فسكنت.
And it also became calm.
فبدأت أقرأ.
So a third time I began to recite.
فاضطربت الخيل.
And again, a third time, it became agitated, the horse. So I was afraid because my child was close to the horse that he may stamp on my child. So I finished my salah. And when I finished the salams, I looked up. I saw a cloud, what looked like a cloud full of light.
كانت قريبة من الأرض فارتفعت إلى السماء.
It was close to the earth and then it ascended up to the heavens.
يقول الصحابي أسيد فذهبت إلى النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم صلاة الفجر.
So this companion Usaid, he said that I prayed Fajr with the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم.
فحدثت النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم بما حصل.
And then I informed him of what took place the previous night.
فقال له النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم.
And the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم said.
تدري ما ذاك؟
Do you know what that was?
قلت له يا رسول الله.
I said, no, Messenger of Allah.
قال تلك الملائكة.
He said, those were the angels.
دنت لصوتك.
They came down because of your voice. And they were listening to you and they were protecting you. And had you continued to recite, the morning would have come and others would have seen the angels there. And they wouldn't have been able to, they wouldn't have shielded themselves from the eyes of others. So connect yourself with the book of Allah and Allah will be with you.
Alhamdulillah.
And all praise is due to Allah.